do we want future generations or even ourselves 10 or 20 or 30 years from now to have a drag on us, almost like debt that we run out and incur? Is that really what we want? Or do we want to sort of pull the band-aid off quickly and allow deflation to give us a painful recessionary year or two, a restructuring of assets, a repricing of assets, new ownership, new boards of directors, new management, whatever it takes, and get back to having an economy with a firmer footing? You know, I would argue that, yes, that is what we'd want, but that requires something called low time preference. And it also requires people who have a less political view of the world. In other words, it's awfully hard to run for office promising pain, right? In the United States, Jimmy Carter famously tried to do that in the 70s, and he was wearing a sweater in front of the fireplace, and everyone turn your thermostat down and save energy, you know? And so everyone in America is like, screw that, we're Americans, let's crank the heat, you know, come on. we never sacrifice, right? We want it all. And so this sort of spreads throughout society in a lot of perverse ways. And so there's a moral and cultural component to how we operate monetary policy. I hope we get into that a little bit. And, you know, it sends all kinds of tremors throughout the economy. It's awfully hard to know. But, you know, whenever it comes to a question of pain now versus pain later, I think we should always choose now.